Hello everyone, my name is Voodoo, and welcome to my guide video for the Spread Eagle build for Mythic Plus. In this video, we'll be going over the talents, rotation, stats, and some of the gear that you need to play this brand new build in Mythic Plus in Season 2 of Dragonflight. So first things first, what is the Spread Eagle build? Well, the Spread Eagle build was a build pioneered by myself, a few others, and named by Fiesta in the Demon Hunter Discord back in like February of this year, 2023. And back then it was a bit of a meme. People felt it was clunky. However, a few things have changed that have brought this build a bit to the forefront. One of those things was a buff, 30% buff to Inner Demon, giving it some more uncapped AoE damage. The other one was our new foreset, and the new foreset does give us lots of Fury generation, which helps to make the build feel less clunky. So those things together have made this build a lot more viable. It already was viable, it just felt a little clunky. However, now it's looking to be a pretty solid option for a ton of different scenarios. People are parsing well with it on Mythic Zakali Assault. Tons of top people are currently playing it out in keys. A lot of that is just like a testing phase, but it is being played there. So I figured today we'd do a bit of a deep dive guide on it. Those of you who missed it, or those of you who want to learn to play this build. So most important thing, of course, is talents. And what are the talents? Well, this is the Spread Eagle build. Now it's named because of this little dip here where it kind of comes into a triangle and spreads out on either side. But the main idea of this build is you come down and grab Glaive Tempest, Inner Demon, and Ragefire. And the combination of these talents gives you a large amount of burst damage. So that's what this build is good at. It's good at really large AoE burst damage. I did this build in a freehold just to test it out. And on like the first pull there, you do everything. I think I was hitting like 800,000 DPS without lust. So you can do a lot of damage with this build. This build, if you're pulling big, if you're pulling around your CDs, you're doing a ton of damage. A lot of your damage comes from Glaive Tempest. It comes from your I-Beam. You have both Blind Fury and Looks Can Kill. Inner Demon does a lot if you have meta, because you get your initial I-Beam gives you one, meta gives you another, and your meta reset from Chaotic Transformation gives you a third. So you're having these hit everybody, critting, dealing a ton of damage. Ragefire accounts for a decent chunk as well. Now it is a little bit less, of course, in this build. We don't have any means necessary, which means that our Growing Inferno and all this stuff is weaker because our Immolation Aura isn't chaos damage, so it doesn't scale off mastery. But it still deals an expectable amount, deals a solid amount of damage, good AoE damage, good uncapped burst. And then you have things on the left side here, like Momentum, Annoy Your Enemy, and Essence Break, just kind of being really strong options to deal damage with. Havoc kind of needs these to work. And then finally, we're just picking up Fodder. Fodder's a good healing survivability tool. It's a good way of getting more burst damage as well. There's just also not really a ton of other places to put this final talent point. Not a ton of things make sense. You could go like, I don't know, Burning Hatred, I guess. But you don't, again, don't really need that Fury generation. And Fodder the Flame is very powerful. On the class tree side, it's your general run-of-the-mill stuff and things are changing. We're taking Misery and Defeat, taking Chaos Nova, taking Demonic, The Hunt, Darkness, all that stuff. It's just, you know, generic, run-of-the-mill, normal stuff that we have. If you need to grab Demon Muzzle, you could drop out Misery and Defeat and Darkness, come down and grab it. Or you could drop out a few other points somewhere else. You can maybe get away with shorter range Disrupt, wouldn't recommend it, but you could try it. So there's a few things you could drop out over there. But pretty standard stuff on the class tree. But again, the spec tree is where it shines. Spread Eagle's coming through here with the large burst with Glaive Tempest, Fodder, Ragefire, Inner Demon. You have Restless Hunter for your burst as well. Increases your Blade Dance during that meta combo, because you're also having Furious Gaze, which means you have enough haste to hit it. So this build looks pretty interesting, looks pretty fun, and does a ton of burst damage. So we'll go over to some target dummies now and do a bit of a rotational guide. So here we are in AoE. Now, there are a few things. The rotation does get a bit busy, and you'll notice we're not using any Glaive talents, but still using Burning Wound. So the way to get around that is you can throw a Glaive out on pull. However, you will probably have to be tab targeting during combat to spread around your Burning Wounds. It's a little thing you've got to remember. It's not the biggest thing in the world, but it is something you want to remember just to get the most out of this build. So we'll go in just like any other build. Start 2 seconds with our thing there, throw a Glaive out, Immolation Aura, rush in The Hunt, and then we're gonna use our trinket. Oh, sorry, that's the Glaive Tempest trinket, rush, I-Beam, Annihilation, Essence Break, Death Sweep, meta, Death Sweep, Annihilation, I-Beam, and then another Glaive Tempest, and then another rush. And you can see here, I did a lot of damage. I did like 400,000, and that was with me goofing a little bit. I used the wrong button. My trick and keybind is a little different on this guy. But from there, the build is honestly pretty simple. You'll notice that at this point, my things are kind of dropped down, so I will have to spread around my burning wounds again. It's not too bad to be just like we were in Shadowland, just spreading it around. But that essentially is the opening rotation. From there, you just are doing a normal build like anything else. You want momentum up for your big hitting abilities like Glaive Tempest, Death Sweep, and Eye Beam. And otherwise, just make sure you keep tab targeting, keep spreading your burning wound around. Just keep up momentum, keep using Eye Beam on cooldown, backflip into Essence Break, and that's really it. So the only complex part is during the opener. Again, you want to start off using your Trinket, then your Glaive Tempest. Use your Glaive Tempest before you enter Eye Beam. If it comes up during an Eye Beam window, you can drop it. However, it is best to use it beforehand, so you never really have that situation. On top of that, you know, momentum is really important to keep up during those moments. So I have Glaive Tempest here, so I'm going to Fel Rush first, so I have momentum for it, and then I'll drop down my Glaive Tempest. Same with Death Sweep. You know, you want to make sure you have momentum for both of these. And a small thing as well is that if you have initiative for your Glaive Tempest, for your hunt, it's very important as well. For the most part, demons should just be cleaved down. If you have one that appears before you use your Essence Break combo, then you can go ahead and just kind of throw Glaive it. But overall, you do want to be using just your abilities to kind of cleave it down. So once more, we'll go in here. I don't have meta, so we'll do a like a smaller one. Open with this, throw a Glaive, Immolation Aura, Fel Rush through, the hunt, drop down our Glaive Tempest, Eye Beam, Annihilation, Backflip, Death Sweep, boom. And then we're just kind of throwing our abilities here until everything runs out. And then we have momentum for Glaive Tempest, boom. So that's kind of it. You're using Glaive Tempest as a really strong, consistent AoE tool. You're having really big burst with things like Inner Demon, things like Rage Fire, things like Restless Hunter. And then your Glaive Tempest, Inner Rage Fire, and your Eye Beam should help to carry you throughout the rest of the pack. So damage is very strong. You see here, a lot of damage from Glaive Tempest, really strong button. And overall, it's just really consistent, strong, bursty build. The single target is worse, and you're gonna do a little bit worse in really giant pulls, as well as you know, places where Rage Fire would be really good. And then as you go further in keys as well, this is built gonna get a bit worse because burst damage in higher keys is just a little bit worse because the pack live for so long. You know, if you're starting to hit a scenario where you can Rage Fire twice in a pack, then this build will start to fall behind. Because again, the Rage Fire, just not very good. But that's kind of the basics for the rotation. Nothing too crazy, nothing too different from what you've done before. As Havoc Demon Hunter, you're just going to rotate in your Glaive Tempest and work it out there. So that is it for the main talent and rotation part. I'm going to do a quick little segment here talking about stats and consumables and all that stuff. But most of this is going to be the same. If you watched my Havoc Season 2 guide, go check that out if you haven't. Very good guide, put a lot of work into it. Doing pretty well too now. It's mostly the same here. So the one difference for stats for Spread Eagle is that crit is going to be your best stat still, and verse is actually your second stat. There's a reason for this. One, haste, not too big of a deal. We're taking Furious Gaze, so we already get enough haste there basically whenever we need it. So haste, not that impactful. It is a little bit better. Mastery, also not that big of a deal because we don't have any means necessary ramping stuff like our Fel Devastation, our Immolation Aura, etc. So in that scenario, versatility becomes our second best stat because we're not really scaling with the other two stats that well. Now, that's not saying the other two stats are bad. Mastery and Haste are both still really solid for this build, but versatility will be your best bet for getting the most mileage out of this. That does lead to a scenario where the three AoE builds we have, Glaive Tempest, this one, and Left Right, want different secondary stats. That's another issue. But for this one right here, you want crit first, versatility second. So for files, consumables, all that stuff, the main one you want to use is the Ice File Crypting Rage. If you need some more verse to live keys, tethered versatility is still really solid for this build because, you know, verse is good. And then for the weapon enchantment, just use the Buzzing Rune for the crit one. The rest of the stuff, use primary stats, use crit and chance, all that stuff. It's going to be the same as the guide, so check out my Havoc guide if you haven't yet. But that is going to be it for the video today. That is my quick little build primer on Spread Eagle. Going to do one of these for all the other builds too, like I did last season, just kind of update people on what's going on with each build and all that stuff. In terms of trinkets, actually, trinkets. So the best trinkets you're going to want for Mythic Plus are going to be the Iridius Fragment and the Beacon of the Beyond. The Ominous Chromatic Essence is really good if you have all five buffs, but if you don't, it's not that good. Other good options, Mark of Draugul. This one does oversim though, so keep that in mind. And then Dice is decent as well for Mythic Plus, so Those are trinkets. Sorry, I forgot about that one when I was doing this. But that now is going to be my Spread Eagle guide. So again, I'm doing one of these for most of the builds. You should see a few more coming up over the next few weeks. So I hope you guys enjoyed. That is going to be it for me today. If you liked the video, drop a like. Comment down below if you have any questions. Or if you enjoyed the video, stuff like that. And hit the sub button. Help spread the video to more people. We are past 5,500 now. We're actually almost to 5,600, which is crazy. So let's see how high we can go. Let's keep pushing the numbers up. Makes me, you know, kind of crazy we can do this together. But I appreciate all of you nonetheless. So that's going to be it for me today. Hope you guys enjoy your Wednesday. I will be streaming tonight, streaming tomorrow. And I will have a video out Friday as well. So I'll see you guys then. Peace. Have a good one. A big shout out to my channel members. Payne, big shout out to you. Metarol, WXZ, Alexandra Goncalves, Damian Polichkin, Osgook, Aiden, DHFG, Jack Gerard, It's Bulk, and Flapjack67. Big shout out to all of them for supporting the channel, allowing me to keep doing this. If you want to help me get a shout out at the end of videos and get another ton of cool perks, there's a link in the description of every video to become a channel member. So click that if you want to learn more. Anyways, thank you to all these people. Big shout out to them. Could not be possible without them. And I'll see you guys next video. Peace.